Hey guys, I'm back. It's Bryce. I'm the co-founder and CEO of CloseBot. Today I wanted to show you how to make an actual job, an AI workflow in CloseBot V2. From our dashboard, we will come over and click on agents. We already have a persona created in here from one of our previous videos, but let's go in here and create a new workflow. I can title this workflow. For this one, I'll just call it testing. I can add it to a group. We allow you to create groups to organize your workflows. And then I'll select the type of flow this is. This is a high level type flow. This cannot be changed later. And this is because we have special automations in each flow type to allow you to interact with these source types. From here, I can select the source that I want. I don't have to at this time, but I do have a source in here that I'd like to connect to. So I'll connect to the testing company. And then I can filter by tags. This version of CloseBot doesn't use workflows in HighLevel or HubSpot at all. You install the source like we did in one of the previous videos, and then you filter by tags and channels. For example, maybe I only want this agent to respond when a contact has the tag CTA. I could do that. Or maybe I only want it to respond when it doesn't have the tag CTA, or AI objectives complete. I could do that. I'll just leave it on the default right now, which is don't respond if it has the tag AI off. That one cannot be removed. Here, I select the channels I want it to respond on. It checks the source type, and we know for GoHighLevel sources and lead connector sources, we can chat on WhatsApp, live chat, Google My Business, SMS, email, Facebook, and Instagram. I can select whichever of these I want it to be able to communicate on. Maybe I want this to be able to communicate on live chat and SMS, but none of the other channels. From here, I can choose to create from a template, create from an AI prompt, or create from scratch. The marketplace is coming. That'll be a place where you can build your own AI workflows and sell them. The AI prompt allows you to prompt to create an AI flow. Maybe you come in and you say, hey, I'm actually building this AI for a dentist office. I need it to be able to conversationally get people's first and last name, email address, and then proceed to get their, whether they're male or female, and then book an appointment. And then it'll build that for you using AI. Let's create from scratch. So now that I'm in the workflow builder, I have some actions that I can use on the right-hand side. And I have my workspace here in the middle. Let's create something very simple here. Let's create a workflow that allows this agent to get first name. And when it gets that, update the variable first name. This is the most important field here. We want to tell it what to do here. Don't tell it, ask what their first name is. Tell it needs to get their first name. We are coming out with a setting that allows you to have AI update this field for you when you select the field type. So this is a very simple AI that just gets first name. But what if we want to get first name and email? Well, we can do it here in the same objective. Just like this. Now, with them both being in the same objective, the AI is going to ask it like, do you mind if I get your first name and email? Instead of asking for one of the things, getting an answer, and then asking for the next thing, it asks them together. And it uses the power of AI to decide how it's gathering that information. Really powerful. Let's take a look at some of these other actions. We'll go deeper on these actions in later videos. We have the section of actions that allows the AI to say something, like the conversation action. which just allows the AI to keep chatting while it's on that. We have the objective, which allows it to gather information and update fields. And we have statement, which allows the AI to just deliver information. When the AI enters into this flow, it always starts here on the main path. So in this example, if I have this on a chat widget on a website, as soon as someone engages, it's going to say, hey, nice to meet you. Could I get your first name and email address? And then once it gets it, it'll come over to here and just be conversational and answer questions. But if we want to be able to jump into a different flow, if it detects something else happening, we can use a scenario. Let's say we want to add a custom scenario. And if we detect the contact wants to book a demo call, so if we detect they want to book a demo call, let's use one of our integration actions and do a booking on a GoHighLevel calendar. The way this will perform, it'll continue on this main flow, continuing here in the conversation section. But if they ever say, hey, can I get a demo of your product? It's free to jump down here and then conversationally book a demo on your GoHighLevel calendar. That's your overview of AI workflows. Now, once we have this workflow created, we can come into settings and you'll see some other areas in the settings. Bot information, you know, why the business is happening, important business information. But also personas. Here is where we add Sam. Sam is going to be the one that's doing this job. Once we add Sam, we can come down and publish.